Hi, my name's Matthew, and I've got something really cool to tell you. Because of my certificate of accounting and bookkeeping, I'm able to take all of this old school textbooks, knowledge, spreadsheets, pen and paper, books, that kind of stuff, and learn how to apply it with the latest technology, like an Excel spreadsheet on a laptop. Accountants today need to be equipped to read data, take the right information found in ledgers and accounts and turn it into useful statistics. It's the classic needle in the haystack. There's all these numbers and information and somewhere in there is a piece of gold. And what I've learned at RMIT is like having a magnet. So you can make decisions based on what you discover. So let's take a closer look. Now, what I have here is an Excel spreadsheet, something that I'm really passionate about, and that's property market and trends. What I've done simply is just imported all this data from real estate companies, from various sources of information that are very easily accessible, and then displaying them in a logical, sequential way. So what I've done is I've allocated it by year, gathered that information, and then looked at it at a simple month-by-month basis and looking at the trends in the information. I can see there's actually some weird things going on in here. So if you take an even closer look, trusting that this data is going to be reliable and accurate, you can see that as the trend is increasing gradually, there's a couple of spikes in the data that don't quite seem to fit. And so when you go for the 2017 sales, about mid-year, you discover that there is in fact not a surge of property, but in fact two properties were purchased at over $1.4 million, which is vastly above what is the expected price of property for that particular time. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to remove that information, and what you're left with is a reliable, accurate spread of data that allows you to predict what's going to happen tomorrow or next week. And you can do this for anything, whether it's planes, trains, automobiles, even footy tipping. Wait, hang on. Okay, that was me. Hang on. No need to panic. Guess who's winning footy tipping at the moment? Because of my certificate, I've been able to land a job at the Australian Tax Office, which is currently undergoing some pretty serious changes. And it's the perfect time getting a certificate and getting this knowledge to land jobs in places like that. I can read the numbers because I have RMIT know-how. If you're interested in the spreadsheet that I used today, you can find a link in the description below.